Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to our channel. Thanks for logging on. If you enjoy these videos, do me a favor and subscribe to our YouTube channel right here at Watchbox Reviews. I would really appreciate it, and I promise to update daily. If you like this watch, you can purchase it on our website, thewatchbox.com. Today, I'm going to discuss a sneaky cool Patek Philippe complication. I say that because this is rarely the annual calendar that people mention when they discuss Patek Philippe's signature complication. And yes, it is a signature. The annual calendar in 1996 was invented by Patek, and this might be its most attractive Patek Philippe packaging. This is the 5205R, the 2013 white opaline dial rose gold model. Easy to wear at 40 millimeters, this is a timepiece often underestimated from the facing soldier shot that you see on the internet. It has incredible grace and nuance about its case form. The watch is reasonably slim. It has a nice concave bezel profile and a rounded case flank that lets it slip underneath any dress cuff. In terms of actual thickness, you're looking at 11.6 millimeters, and on my 16 centimeter circumference wrist, you can see it wears easily. Lug to lug, it measures 49.6, so Patek allowed those lugs to flow and arc, to have a sculptural form, beauty, and presence of their own. Oftentimes, on modern watches, they're just so darn big that the lugs are stubs. They don't have much sculptural form or presence. This is the opposite of that practice. Between the lugs, you will find a 20 millimeter spacing so you can easily accessorize, but give the factory strap a chance. It's nicely made, slim in profile, with large semi-gloss rectangular scale alligator leather in dark brown, monotone stitch, folded edge, calfskin on the underside. It uses Patek Philippe's signature pull-tabs pin buckle so you can easily remove the shoes for close cleaning between the lugs or to change the look of your watch, and of course, a handsome polished and faceted Patek Philippe rose gold spade style pin buckle for a low and traditional profile. When I mentioned that this watch sneaks up on you, I'm really talking about the case profile, because it has immense nuance. This could be a case by Moser. It's that fluid, it's that sinuous. Look at those evacuated lugs. Those aren't simply drilled out lugs. They have a tapering aperture that ends in a straight through relief. Absolutely gorgeous, and I love the way they have a sculptural compound curved profile that plays with the light almost like fire. At off angles, it's incredibly beguiling, and even head on, it has a hypnotic complexity about it. This is the kind of thing you expect on something like a Flinke enamel dial, not a case. The bezel continues the trend of thoughtful sculpting. You see, there's a strong step between the case band and the bezel. That's one of the few hard surfaces and hard, sharply defined lines of the watch. Almost everything else is fluid, graceful, blended. And that's true of the concave profile of the bezel, which visually pares down the mass of this rather sizable Patek Philippe. Now, getting close to the dial, you can see it features a metallic sector profile. So you have a sector dial, but executed with metal polished chapter rings, and then the cross beams of the sector, applique rose gold, diamond polished, faceted, and hand applied, with a rose gold dimple style minute and seconds track outboard, and rose gold lancet counterweighted seconds hand and faceted Dauphine style hands at center. There's a 24 hour scale at 6 o'clock coaxial with a crescent style moon phase. So that 24 hour scale is both your AM PM for the time at center. It lets you know whether you're looking, for example, at 2:51 in the morning or 2:51 in the afternoon. You can see the indicator is between 2 and 4, so it is in the morning. And that's your no-go zone. That's how you know when not to try to set the annual calendar using the pusher adjusters. And you have a simple, easily referenced aperture-style calendar system. I love this. First, I love the balance of it. Threes are downright Shakespearean in their symmetry. You'll note the one at center features a rose gold aperture, so splits the flanking indications because the date is principal, it is prime, it is the one you are most likely to reference, so it takes pride of place at the top with its own gold faceting. But you have the day, the date, and the month easily laid out. If you've ever seen a radially indicated calendar, they're handsome, but at the same time, and here's a longer annual, they can be somewhat difficult to read, even if you have sharp eyes. This is much easier, both because you know exactly where to look, and because other days, dates, and months aren't competing for your attention on the same dial register. Turn it all over, and you can see it's as beautifully sculpted on the crown side, and you have a gorgeous Patek Philippe 324 automatic. So this is the 324 QALU24. All of those alphas in the numeric, representing the functions of the movement. So 324 is the base caliber, LU is your moon phase, 24 is the 24-hour indication, and QA is quantième annuel. So you have that annual calendar that requires adjustment once per year during the transition from February to March. The balance beats away at 4 hertz, or 8 beats per second, 28,800 vibrations per hour. You will note that it features a Gyromax-style free-sprung balance, so it can take and hold its 6-position regulation. Yes, 6, not the chronometer standard 5. And it has a Spiromax silicon hairspring for anti-magnetism, both Gyromax and Spiromax being Patek Philippe innovations. Unidirectional winding for efficiency, ceramic rotor bearings for still greater efficiency, as well as long-wearing durability. They operate unlubricated. The rotor itself features an engraved Calatrava cross, circular Cote de Genève, and a micro-spiral perlage at center. There's a larger perlage pattern and engine turning underneath the balance itself. 35 to 45 hour power reserve. You can see linear Cote de Genève laid down with an abrasive wheel, not stamped, perfectly aligned across the bridges. A special jig is used to ensure that alignment. And if I turn it flush to the camera, you can start to see the edges of the bridges, the jewels, and the screw countersinks all glowing, because those countersinks, as well as the bridge corners, are perfectly rounded, optically smooth, and mirrored. That is the anglage of which you may have heard, the rounded polishing of the edge of a bridge, originally designed to remove the burrs from the edge of machined parts and cut parts. Historically, that would prevent the watchmaker's tool from chipping off an errant piece of loose metal during the servicing process. Over time, anglage became a purely aesthetic finishing tradition, but it has functional roots, and that's why it's there. You'll also note that all of the screw heads are black polished. The movement beautifully executed, featuring the Patek Philippe seal. While less romantic than the old Geneva Hallmark, it comes with a timing guarantee. Patek promises that those movements with the Patek Philippe seal will keep time to -3 seconds, +2 seconds per day or better. Put that claim to the test with the 5205R on the watch box.